Hey everyone, and welcome to my channel. Today, we're diving into the world of electroplating, specifically the fascinating processes of zinc and nickel electroplating. These techniques are incredibly useful for protecting and enhancing metals, and I'll break down everything you need to know. Let's get started. What is electroplating? First off, what exactly is electroplating? In a nutshell, it involves using an electrical current to coat a metal object with a thin layer of another metal. This is done for several reasons: improving corrosion resistance, boosting durability, and giving a shiny, decorative finish. Zinc electroplating is widely used because it's a cost-effective way to protect steel and other ferrous metals. It works like this. The process: the metal object you want to coat is the cathode, the negative electrode. A piece of pure zinc is the anode, the positive electrode. Both are submerged in a special solution containing zinc ions. When we pass electricity through the setup, zinc ions from the solution get deposited onto the object, creating a protective layer. Benefits of zinc electroplating: sacrificial protection. Zinc is more reactive than steel. This means it corrodes first, sacrificing itself to protect the underlying steel like a shield. Affordability: zinc is an abundant and relatively inexpensive metal, making the process cost-effective. Versatility: zinc electroplating works well on various shapes and sizes of metal objects. Nickel electroplating. Nickel electroplating offers a different set of benefits. The process: it's similar to zinc. You have your metal object as the cathode and a piece of pure nickel as the anode. However, the electrolyte solution contains nickel ions instead. Benefits of nickel electroplating: superb corrosion resistance. Nickel forms a tough, durable barrier that resists rust and chemicals exceptionally well. Attractive finish. Nickel plating gives a bright, lustrous finish, making it popular for decorative applications. Hardness and wear resistance. Nickel plating increases the surface hardness, making parts more resistant to scratches and wear. Zinc versus nickel. Which is better? It's not about one being better than the other. Here's how to decide. Need maximum corrosion protection? Go with zinc, especially in harsh environments. Its sacrificial nature is your best bet. Prioritizing looks or hardness, nickel is the winner. It offers superior shine and surface durability. Is budget a big factor? Zinc electroplating tends to be more affordable. DIY electroplating, a word of caution. A quick note: while DIY electroplating kits are available, please proceed with caution. These chemicals can be dangerous if not handled properly. Do your research and always prioritize safety. Applications of electroplating. Where do we see electroplating in action? Everywhere. Automotive industry, plating car parts for both protection and looks. Manufacturing, coating tools and machinery to enhance their lifespan. Jewelry and decorative items, creating beautiful shiny finishes. Electronics, plating circuit boards and contact. There you have it. I hope you enjoyed this deep dive into zinc and nickel electroplating. If you found this helpful, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more awesome content. Thanks for watching. Let me know if you'd like visuals, more technical details, or even a practical demonstration of the electroplating process in a future video. I'm always happy to customize content for you.